Authentication apps protect your account by adding second-factor codes for account access. What they don't tell you is the codes can easily be wiped out and you won't get access to your accounts. Today, we'll prepare you for that disaster. Hello, everyone. This is Rick with Cybermedics. Should you be concerned with what will go wrong with second-factor authentication apps? Codes can be deleted accidentally, devices will get lost or broken, 2FA apps can crash. Yes, you should be concerned. Today, we will prepare you for any disaster, human or natural, to reacquire your 2FA codes. The three accounts we're going to use for examples are Tutanota, ProtonMail, and Zoho. The video is broken up into three main parts. First part is to create and capture all relevant TOTP information for each account. Next, we'll cover how to secure the account information and protect it. And finally, we'll walk through the scenario you've lost access to all your accounts and your devices, and you need to recreate your TOTP accounts. Before we dive into securing your 2FA codes, we'll do a brief explainer of second-factor authentication. It's something you know, plus something you have, or something you are. There's a link to a video we went into great detail on second-factor. If you need more information, please click on the link above. When you add an account to an authentication application, the procedure is pretty much the same on all of the applications. You say add an account, scan a QR code, put your camera over the QR code, and the account is added. We'll now go into each of the three mail systems and add the authentication app to each one. Under Tutanota here, you have to select the authentication application TOTP. The first thing we'll do is a screen capture of the TOTP information. And once we've copied that, we'll take and put it into a file. Next, we'll copy the security key, which is graphically represented within the QR code. Now we'll go on to ProtonMail. We'll click second factor authentication. Click next. We'll scan the QR code. And I like to capture the whole screen here in case there's other information that you might need to be aware of. Now we'll paste it into our file. We'll click on the enter manual key because we want to make a copy of that. Now we'll go over to Zoho. Now we'll click change the configuration. Put that into our file, copy the manual security key here. Now the next step we're going to do is we're going to use the Google Authenticator to scan and confirm each of these QR codes. So we'll click get started, say scan a QR code, and now it scanned the QR code. So we'll click over here and add the TOTP number. You want to make sure that you get your backup recovery codes. Now you want to copy this recovery code and put it into the file that you're generating. And then we're done with that account. Next, we'll go into ProtonMail and we'll add that account. Come over to the application and say add a new account. And we'll say scan a QR code. Click next. We've entered the password and now we have to enter the second factor authentication number from over here. We need to take a screenshot of this, paste that into our file. Select OK. Next, we'll go into the Zoho account, scan the QR code, select Next. Now it's asking us to put in the TOTP code on the right, verify. Now we're going to do something that's unique to the Google Authenticator app. We're going to come up here and export the accounts. This is one of the things I really like about Google Authenticator. And you can select individual accounts or all the accounts. We're going to export all of them. And that's going to give us a combined QR code. And what we're going to do is screen capture that code, put that into our file under the Google section. In addition, what we're going to do is capture a screenshot of the accounts that are on that consolidated code. We'll paste those into our file. The reason that's important is because you have this consolidated QR code. If you paste a screenshot of the accounts, then you know for sure what accounts are represented in this code. Now what we're going to do is put this file into a PDF. We're going to call it Consolidated Codes PDF. And here you'll see we have all the codes. Now we're going to encrypt the file. You can use whatever encryption software you choose. I'm using 7-zip here. Here you can set the archive format. We're going to select zip. You can come down and select the encryption method and put a password on it. Say OK. Now you can see we have the file. We will click on the file just to make sure that we have access to it through the password. And there we go. There is the file. The next step I recommend here is that you print this out on a piece of paper and store it in a safe, a physical safe. That way, if technology fails you, you could always go in and get the piece of paper and reconstitute the codes. All right, next we want to take the file and upload it to a cloud storage provider. In this case, we're going to use Bitwarden. If you have the paid subscription, you can upload secure attachments to your vault. I recommend using any cloud provider that would allow you to use a hardware security key to secure your account. So in Bitwarden, you go to your vault and just click add an item. We're going to select secure note, give it a name, QR code demo, descriptor, and save. Now we'll come over to the three dots and select attachments. Choose a file. Choose our encrypted consolidated file and save. Now you can see the attachment is there. So now we're going to go through the scenario. We've lost our devices, we've lost our app. Whatever reason, we've lost all of our codes. Because we have cloud storage of a secure encrypted QR consolidated file, we can reconstitute our accounts on new devices. So we go into Bitwarden or whatever cloud provider you have, and we find that attachment, and we download it. Show in folder. Now we're going to open it, type in our password, and now here's our file. Next, we'll call up the Google Authenticator app, and we will delete all of the codes off of the app. We're recreating the accounts on new devices. Now remember, this is the Google consolidated QR code. Get started, scan a QR code. Now that is really neat because you just scan one QR code. That's why I like Google Authenticator application, especially if you're on the iOS system, because you can have a screen lock tied to your Face ID. It's one scan and you've got all your codes back instantly. Next, we'll call up the Yubico Authenticator app. This consolidated code is only compatible with Google Authenticator. Here, we have to scroll down to the individual codes that we added. We'll say add, scan a QR code. Whoops. I accidentally hit the key. Let's try that again. I have a key plugged into it because Yubico stores these TOTP codes on a security key. It's one of the security features that a lot of people like about the Yubico. And we'll select scan a QR code, save, and scan. See how simple this is? And we're doing this on three different authentication applications, right? So no matter what happens or what app's available to you, I want to show you something unique that I do like about this. I'm going to pull the key out, and now you can see all the codes are gone. In addition, you can add a password, which I recommend if you're going to store your TOTP codes on the security key. Next, we'll run through the process again with Microsoft Authenticator. So we'll come in here, click Add an Account, scan the QR code. Next, we'll go to Zoho, add an account. The codes are all in sync. There is a feature I want to show you about Microsoft Authenticator. We have a link to a video that we did deep dive into its capabilities. To turn on the cloud backup here, It's going to back them up to whatever Microsoft Outlook account you have on the application. You say, okay. That way, if you lost your device and you wanted to recreate the accounts, you would be able to do that through the cloud backup. So it's just another layer of protection that you have that's built into Microsoft Authenticator. We're going to recap best practices that we walked through. Whenever you're adding a QR code, it's best to get this secret text copy of it in case for some reason you couldn't scan this. You could always manually enter the code. Once you have all your codes consolidated, recommend printing them out on a piece of paper and storing them in a physical safe. Once they're stored in a physical safe, take those and electronically put them into an encrypted file. Place that encrypted file into a cloud storage system, preferably two different providers. Also, ones that will allow you to lock it down with a FIDO2 compliant hardware security key. Once you've completed that process, download the file, unencrypt it, and recreate the accounts on an Authenticator application to make sure that everything went well. That's exactly the procedure that we followed in this detailed video. And if you've done all that, give yourself an A+. That's a wrap on how to protect your second factor authentication accounts. Hope you'll give the video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. This supports our efforts in helping others with technology. Please post any comments or questions below and have a great and wonderful automation day.